bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, let us feel your compassion more readily during these days when, by your gift, we have known it more fully, so that those you have freed from the darkness of error may cling more firmly to the teachings of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, saying, "Be ready to set out at noon along the road that goes from Jerusalem down to Gaza, the desert road." So he set off on his journey. Now it happened that an Ethiopian had been on a pilgrimage to Jerusalem. He was an eunuch and an officer at the court of the Kandake, or Queen of Ethiopia, and was in fact her chief treasurer. He was now on his way home, and as he sat in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go up and meet that chariot." When Philip ran up, he heard him reading Isaiah the prophet, and asked, "Do you understand what you are reading?" "How can I," he replied, "unless I have someone to guide me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit by his side. Now the passage of scripture he was reading was this: "Like a sheep that is led to the slaughterhouse, like a lamb that is dumb in front of his shearers, like these he never opens his mouth. He has been humiliated and has no one to defend him. Who will ever talk about his descendants, since his life on earth has been cut short?" The eunuch turned to Philip and said, "Tell me, is the prophet referring to himself or someone else?" Starting, therefore, with this text of scripture, Philip proceeded to explain the good news of Jesus to him. Further along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, there is some water here. Is there anything to stop me being baptized?" He ordered the chariot to stop. Then Philip and the eunuch both went down to the water, and Philip baptized him. But after they had come out of the water again, Philip was taken away by the Spirit of the Lord, and the eunuch never saw him again, but went on his way rejoicing. Philip found that he had reached Azotus and continued his journey, proclaiming the good news in every town as far as Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response to the psalm is, "Cry out with joy to God all the earth." O people, bless our God. Let the voice of his praise resound, of the God who gave life to our souls and kept our feet from stumbling. Come and hear, all who fear God. I will tell what he did for my soul. To him I cried aloud, with high praise ready on my tongue. Blessed be God, who did not reject my prayer, nor withhold his love for me. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord who hung for us on the tree has risen from the tomb. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, "No one can come to me unless he is drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, they will be taught by God and hear the teaching of the Father and learn from me. Is to come to me. Not that anybody has seen the Father except the one who comes from God. He has seen the Father. I tell you most solemnly, everybody who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate manna in the desert, and they are dead. But this is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that a man may eat it and not die. I am the living bread which has come down from heaven. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Historians can be fairly sure that the Coptic Church in Ethiopia is one of the oldest Christian traditions in our faith. It is thought that probably they would have originated in about the 1st century AD. And I suppose it's highly likely that this character that we hear Philip meeting in today's Gospel may have been one of the first evangelists in Ethiopia. This Ethiopian eunuch was returning from Jerusalem after a pilgrimage to the temple. And he meets Philip, who tells him of the good news, and through this eunuch is baptized, and he goes on his way home, and as I mentioned, probably to proclaim this new faith that he had received. Jesus, throughout his ministry, always told us that the Christian faith would not be, good news rather, would not just be for the people of Israel, but rather for the whole world. It seems as if maybe this was one of the first times that this Christian message would go beyond the rounds of the Holy Land. We are recipients of that good news some 2,000 years or so later. That does not mean that we need to stop in our mission proclaiming that good news in our lives, so that the good news can reach further throughout our world. So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers of intercession this day. We pray for the Church that it may always continue the missionary work and portray the good news to all the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our world and its many needs. We pray for peace and we pray for those other parts of our world torn apart by war and bloodshed. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all victims of war and terror. We pray that they in some way may find peace for the rest of their lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in mind or in body, that they may find healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur at this time. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of Heaven, as we pray together.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now.
All our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O God of all creation, for through your goodness we have the spread to all. Which earth has given and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, O God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church.
The God who, by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ, Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to claim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to Lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Glory, 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 Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, as with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Bernadette, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away our sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Bless us. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from this former way to newness of life. Through Christ.
Amen.
Just to mention that there will be Mass here next Thursday, as I am in a meeting in Bristol, and so there will be. The church will be open for exposition from 9:30 till 10:30. So if you wish to come along for quiet prayer, then please do. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is
thanks be to God.